Good evening, everybody, and welcome to all of you here. Welcome to all of you that are on the live stream this evening. It's been a difficult week here at UVA, as you all know, and so we are very glad to be with you this evening to share the music. I will say more about all that later on. This evening, we're doing a program that is about music written for or about Cecilia, Saint Cecilia, who is the patron saint of music, as I'm sure you all know. Her feast day is celebrated November 22nd. So today being the 20th, we're very close in time to when people tend to do concerts in honor of Cecilia. And the whole program will reflect different sides of music written for her and so on. And I wanted to start with a chant from the wonderful Hildegard von Bingen, because I've thought more than once, if Cecilia had not been made the patron saint of music, Hildegard might have been. And so we wanted to open up with that. And by the way, I wanted to also mention, if you saw it, some of you may have seen there was, in addition to your written program, a QR code which has all the text tonight online if you want to follow that on your phone. And because there's a lot of beautiful text and words that will sing for you tonight. So that was Hildegard, and now I have an interesting story. We were next going to do from you, and still are going to do from you, a piece by Howells with a text by Ursula von Williams. And yes, she is related. She was the wife of von Williams, Ray von Williams, and a very distinguished poet and writer in her own right. And she collaborated with other composers, including Howells, which we'll hear. This piece calls for choir and organ. And I decided that we would use the hall organ. I haven't used it in over a decade. And the reason I haven't, and others haven't, is because it's extremely fussy. And all I can tell you is it sounded great on Thursday. And we turned it on tonight, and it has about five ciphers all in a very non-Howells-esque cluster. So we will have to do this with piano. And I'm sorry, but that's how it goes with a fussy organ. So if you want to write your organ congressman and say, we need a better organ, or whatever, you know, whatever we need to redo. In any case, that's probably above my pay grade tonight. But we're still happy to do this for you. It's a beautiful piece. Enjoy it.
Words of youth and phrases.
you very much. Next time with Oregon. Back in the 1600s in England, they started having concerts on St. Cecilia's Day to celebrate music making, and composers would write new pieces. And we have several of those for you tonight. And the first is this tremendous piece by Purcell. He wrote it in 1683, and it was premiered on St. Cecilia's Day. And it's called Welcome to All the Pleasures. And we're going to have our old friends, Three Notched Road, Baroque Ensemble. We've collaborated with them before several times. And I'm very happy to welcome them back to the stage. And so would you help me welcome them as they come out, Three Notched Road. Thank you.
Oh,
Thank you so much, and we will have Three Notch Road back in a moment. And by the way, all the soloists in that, save one, were students, which is wonderful, lovely opportunity, wonderful talent. And also, the other soloist, our countertenor tonight, James Atkins, actually sings in the community course I direct, the Oratorio Society. And someone said to me earlier this fall, they said, you know, James is a good countertenor. And I said, I mean, he sings tenor in the choir. I said, really? And so there you go. That was lovely. Lovely to have. This next piece is what I would call a virtuosic piece for chorus. It's about 10 minutes, fully a cappella, by Benjamin Britten, his hymn to St. Cecilia. We did it with chamber singers, I would say, about 12 years ago, the last time we did it. It's a very special piece. You'll hear it in many different sections. The Auden text, the W.H. Auden text that he set, is amazing. And if you don't have it on your phone, I encourage you after the concert to just go home and look up this text. Extremely beautiful and powerful and complex. He and Britten knew each other and interesting relationship. And I think where sometimes Auden is talking about Cecilia, he's also talking a little bit about Britten. And so I hope you enjoy this amazing, wonderful piece, Benjamin Britten's Hymn to St. Cecilia.
In our
Thank you very much. I'm glad we could do that piece for you, even though we've had some shortened rehearsal for various reasons. But I'm glad that you could hear that. And if you want, go take some more listens to it on recording or whatever. That's a tremendous choral piece. One of my favorites, actually. Really quite amazing. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. You know how they used to say, don't try that at home. That's one of those that's one of those pieces. It's quite challenging. Next, we're going to do for you an excerpt from a Handel ode for St. Cecilia's Day. This chorus is called From Harmony. It's one of the better known excerpts from this piece. We're going to welcome back Three Notch Road. And I just wanted to tell you a couple interesting things to listen for. So in this piece, Handel channels this idea that the universe sprang from sound. And so you hear this idea from harmony to heavenly harmony, the universe, the universal frame began. And when he says the word harmony, you'll see after a little while he starts having fun and he works through various different chords and key areas. And then when he gets to the part in the music where it says, through all the compass of the notes it ran, you will start hearing the chorus go up and down on scales, and then you'll hear the instrumentalists start running all around the place through all the compass of the notes. So enjoy this Handel. thank you, and thanks again to Three Notch Road for joining us. We're thrilled to collaborate again with them, and hopefully will again soon. To all of you, I want to say again, before our last number, thank you so much for joining us for this St. Cecilia concert. To all those of you online, thank you for joining us. I just want to go back to the thing I mentioned at the top of the program, and that is that, as you know, it's been a very difficult week here at our beloved UVA. You'll see all the students are wearing the orange ribbon, and we wore those also when we sang yesterday in the pre-service at the memorial at JPJ. Both the chamber singer sang and the university singer sang, and we were very honored to be part of that ceremony, very solemn occasion. And I've been trying to listen carefully to the students this week. I was thinking of adding a piece to this program as a reflection, and actually they kind of convinced me that we already had that piece on our program in this last piece, Let Beauty Be Our Memorial. Let me say a word about that, and then I'll say one thing about our students, and then we'll be ready to go for the evening. The last composer, Jack Redford, who I hope may be watching with us online, he is a composer where even if you don't recognize his name, I am confident that you have heard his musical work. Because in addition to being a composer in his own right, he is also a major figure in Hollywood, particularly in orchestration. So if you have seen Skyfall or Avatar, you have heard his work among many other films. And so we're thrilled to do, again, some of his music here. We sang this piece yesterday at the memorial. It's called Let Beauty Be Our Memorial. The words are his own. And he told me about this because he wrote it for a concert that was on a St. Cecilia's Day program. A friend of his was doing this particular reason, a solemn reason they did that. All of you who know American history will know that November 22nd is not only St. Cecilia's Day, it's also, of course, sadly, the day that JFK was assassinated. And so there are pieces written for that as well, and I think Jack had both Cecilia and that in mind when he wrote this. So you'll hear that in a minute. Before I bring the students forward to sing this, just a reminder, we have some more wonderful concerts coming up after Thanksgiving, including the family holiday concerts with the University Singers and the Charlottesville Symphony. The info on that is in your program. There are ways in the lobby at our table to make donations both to UVA choral music, but also we have put a QR code out there tonight for the UVA Strong Fund, which is to benefit the families most affected by the events earlier this week. So we invite you to stop there on your way out, and we thank you again for coming. I want to say lastly, there was some conversation whether we would have any of our concerts this week, and I'm glad we could just open it up to the public this evening, and that after talking with the students, they felt it was very important that we keep singing, as I did. I hate to use this quote again because I feel like I have to use it too often, but you know I am a big Bernstein fan. Leonard Bernstein said in November 1963, this will be our reply to violence, to make music more intensely, more beautifully, and more devotedly than ever before. And so in some small way, that is what we are here continuing to try to do this week here for you in our community and for our students. So I'm very proud of them for being here this evening, and they're going to come down here to the front of the stage and sing this last piece for you. Thank you so much.